We have breaking news this hour. A family in Sydney's west is suffering suspected carbon monoxide poisoning after falling asleep in front of a heater while trying to keep warm overnight. Gabrielle Boyle is there for us in Maryland's this morning. Gabby, the family has been rushed to hospital.
They certainly have, Ali. When paramedics got a call to this Maryland's granny flat in the early hours of this morning, it didn't sound like anything too serious. It was reports of an adult with a headache. But when they arrived at the scene, it was something very different. Six people who had all suffered carbon monoxide poisoning, four adults and two children. Four adults all raced to Westmead Hospital, the two children, Westmead Children's Hospital. Police, paramedics and Fire and Rescue New South Wales all tell us they believe it was a charcoal heater, which has caused this carbon monoxide poisoning, and that this outdoor heater may have been bought indoors. Sadly, we've reported on these stories in the past, people using these outdoor heaters indoors when it's simply too expensive to run their air conditioning or their heaters. A full investigation is now underway. Ali?
Thanks, Gabby.
It's been labelled a mandate by stealth. Victorian parents told this morning by the government to send their kids to school with face masks. We have reporters covering every angle of this story this morning. First to Christine Ahern in Melbourne. Chris, how are parents feeling this morning about it all?
Well, Carl, the parents I've spoken to here this morning don't think it's too much of a big deal. This is after a letter was emailed to them last night, signed by the heads of government, independent and Catholic schools, asking for children to wear masks in school once again. So this letter in part reads, we're asking all students aged 8 and over and all staff in all schools across Victoria to wear masks in class from now until the end of winter. Students won't be required or expected to wear masks when outdoors. Now, the Victorian Education Minister is adamant this is not a mask mandate. Rather, it is something that is just strongly recommended. Either way, this one parent I spoke to said she's fine with it.
If that's what they have to do to keep us all safe, I'm absolutely happy with that.
Now, she's a parent of a high school student. It's a little trickier with primary school students, and this school here will be opening in under an hour. We'll get some reaction then. Carl?
Christine, thank you.
Daily average hospital admissions are at an all-time high in Queensland after modelling failed to predict the severity of this latest wave. Jessica Millwood is in Brisbane. Jess, while hospitalisations are high, those needing intensive care, fairly low.
Yeah, that's right, Ali. If there's any good news in all of this, we are seeing a third of what we saw in January, people being admitted to ICU with COVID, but those being admitted to hospital is far greater. And the health minister says that this current wave is now more severe than any modelling had predicted, and they do not know what is going to come next. They do know that the peak won't be for several weeks yet. We've got around 2,500 health staff off being sick. That's about 7%, and staff shortages are really hitting aged care hard as well, with fresh calls this morning for the military assistance to be extended.
Staff's our big challenge. So while we're better protected in terms of rapid antigen tests, PPE, the antivirals I mentioned, our big weakness is staff numbers.
During the January wave, 30% of aged care staff were off with COVID. And if you think we're now in uncharted territory, this wave expected to be far worse. It could reach crisis levels. As for masks here in Queensland, well, the Premier is strongly urging teachers and students to wear them in schools. Ali?
Thanks, Jess.
The nation's electricity market could be plunged into a fresh crisis as gas shortages loom in Victoria. Levels at Victoria's underground gas storage plant, Iona, have dropped to a record low. It's forced the market operator to put an official system security threat in place until the end of September. A European summer from hell is looming for hundreds of airline passengers who are facing major wait times as post-COVID chaos impacts airports across the globe. Lara Vella's at Sydney Airport this morning for us. Lara, good morning. Heathrow is asking airlines to stop selling tickets.
Yeah, Alex, at the moment, the situation is being described as Airmageddon at Heathrow Airport. And really, you've got a combination of factors at play here. There are too many passengers, too many flights coming in, and quite simply, not enough staff to process them all. So as a result, well, the airport has now reached out to global airlines asking for their help. Qantas has now responded, Alex, by making some adjustments to its scheduled flight QF2 departing from Heathrow, London today and arriving in Sydney just after 5 o'clock on Thursday morning. It means that the flight will now take off 9 hours earlier. In addition to that, the stopover in Singapore will now be 11 hours. Those passengers, though, will be offered accommodation by Qantas. Now, Alex, we spoke to some passengers here at the Sydney International Terminal who were flying Qantas today and asked them whether they would prefer to have 20 hours extra flying time added to their journey or whether they would like to see the flight cancelled and rescheduled. Here's some of their responses.
I would prefer to have the stopover in Singapore and get on the flight.
It's more convenient than it being cancelled. I'm much happier with clear communication.
I don't know, actually. But I love the straight flight.
Alex, I've had an update from Qantas this morning. They say today's QF2 is the only flight that's going to be impacted.
Well done, Lara. Thank you. Meantime, Europe is right now going through an unprecedented heat wave. As temperatures soar across the UK, Wales has recorded its hottest day on record today at 37.1 degrees. Passengers travelling on this Spanish train were alarmed as their train was forced to stop as wildfires surrounded them on both sides of the track. A man's recovering after being rescued in waters off the coast of Perth. The man was found with a snapped surf ski 4 kilometres out from the Mindari coast after calling for help. That is a long way out, especially in those waters. Yeah. The Nine News helicopter guided police to the man before he was taken back to shore without injury.
Let's get some weather.
Sorry, I asked.
With Timmy. Yes. Silly question, Ellie. Timmy, good morning.
Hi, guys. Are you ready for a little bit of a sing-along as you get excited for the weekend there? Well, we have the Senior Hearts Choir standing by to do exactly that for us in just a sec. But I just had to introduce to you Mrs. Andrea Bridge, who is stepping in for the regular music teacher, Sophie Hodson. Hi, Sophie, if you're watching this morning. Andrea, my goodness me, 32 years you have been teaching. You have been teaching Brisbane, Bundaberg, Toowoomba, the Territory, the Gold Coast. Mm-hmm. 32 years. Why do you do it?
Why do I do it? It's the best job in the world, Tim.
Yeah.
Who would not want to come and teach these beautiful kids?
Yeah.
They teach me something every day.
Really? Who's teaching
Simple
who?
Simple as that.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Who's teaching who? That's
you'd,
right.
You'd hear some interesting things. Yeah. Also some beautiful things as a music teacher, as a primary teacher. You're qualified in both areas. These guys, they are ready to roll. They sound absolutely superb. So we're going to get a little bit of different people stand together. They really celebrate diversity here at Junction Park State School. So we'll hear the kids in just a sec. But first, a look at your forecast on this Tuesday morning. Good morning to you again, Cairns. The top today of 26 degrees, Brisbane mostly sunny and 21. For Sydney, some showers around 14 degrees, wet throughout the rest of the week. For Canberra, morning frost clearing, making way for a partly cloudy high of 12. 12 degrees also the top for Melbourne and mostly sunny. Partly cloudy for Hobart and for Adelaide. For Perth today, mostly sunny, 19 degrees. Alice Springs, sunny and 25 degrees. And Darwin for you, sunny and a top of 30.
Are you ready?
Beautiful,
so sweet,
kids.
Isn't it? Well done.
Please, sir, more. What a lovely set of voices right there.